Alright, hey Jogi420, hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome to John Sweet Pea Recovers from Illness. I'm actually testing to see if I've recovered from illness now. And to do this, I'm going to begin the Woo campaign for the Dynasty Warriors 8 Xtreme Legends. Yeah. So I was debating whether to tick between Wu or Shu, or the next faction to play as in Dynasty Warriors 8 Xtreme Legends. Merry Christmas. And a Merry Christmas to you too. Yogi48Tor20. Harrison Smith said that Shu's campaign kind of ends with the start of Jin's campaign. So, historically wise, it makes a bit more sense to play as Wu next, and then move on to Shu. Further after. So, with that in mind, I will be playing as Wu next in line. Based on the historical timeline, I guess. Which, I guess, would make things a bit more fun. I mean, Wei seemed to have finished the earliest. I'm guessing maybe even on the menu option it's been scrolled from earliest to latest in the kingdoms. So, it should be fun to play as the entirely new faction in this game, having been very used to the Wei folk and all the chaos and ambition and stuff. Let's see how Wu operates, shall we? Oh, we can take an early look at the stages. Wow. Well, ignoring the fact that they have 8 Xtreme Legends stages, their first mission already has a branch-off point. Already. Their first mission has already an alternate branching line. That's the first mission. Dang, this is going to be interesting, I think. Alright. So, without further ado, let us play the Wu faction and see what they are like. And I will be sticking to the normal difficulty because I don't feel being on hard is a good idea for any time during the first time playthrough of any of the campaigns. So normal it will be. Approaching the end of the Eastern Han Dynasty, long-standing rule of the Han Imperial Court was on the brink of collapse. Religious cults, tyrannical eunuchs, and other traitorous elements looked to seize power for themselves, threatening the very land itself. In an effort to right these wrongs, heroes from around the land rose up in unison. Sun Jian, a descendant of Sun Tzu, the author of the Art of War, was counted among their ranks. During the campaign against the traitor Dong Zhuo, Sun Jian had made an amazing discovery within Muo Rang. He had found the legendary Imperial Seal, which served as a symbol to rule over the people of the land. However, upon hearing this news, the nobleman Wan Shao immediately set out in pursuit of Sun Jian. As a result, Sun Jian turned to Wan Shu for assistance, who was in opposition to Wan Shao. In exchange for offering his protection, Wan Shu ordered Sun Jian to attack Du Biao in Xiangyang. Sun Jian's children, Sun Sei, Sun Quan, Sun Shangjiang, as well as his right-hand man Han Dong. The army of the Tiger of Jiangdong would use its might to carve open a path towards destiny. Okay, so the very first mission is we basically are helping out Wan Shu of all people. Huh. Should be interesting. Interesting indeed. So we're going to be playing the, so we have 4 options in the chat, and all of these will be new picks, since some of them have their skills equipped, and all level 1. Everyone will start at level 1 and will have to be worked up to decent levels. So 4 choices, which means all new characters. We have Sun Shangjiang. We have Sun Quan, Sun Sei, and Han Dong, who previously was a generic. So, who do you reckon I should play as then, Chet, for my first Wu campaign pick? Got four delightful options here. Who to pick? The chat will be getting a lot of choice throughout this campaign, since it's starting from fresh, and thus all the characters will be new. However, if any new characters, if any characters come up more than once, I will bump them off the list. So, once again, I will be trying to play as a new character each mission as much as possible. So, for example, if I pick, so sample, say, if Sun Quan gets picked this time around, and he comes up in the next mission character roster, I will try not to pick him for that one. But then, because we have skills, we'll know exactly who I've played as. It won't be like before, we didn't have skills to start with. I'll know exactly who I've played as, because every character will have the same skills assigned to him. So, who should I play as, Chet? Who would you like to see first from the Wu campaign this Christmas Eve? Please pick somebody. Those are things about the game I didn't understand. Oh, okay. What things are you referring to, Jorgie? Soon. You reckon I should pick Sun Quan? Okay, well, we'll see if anyone else has a Hello, Tolau. How's it going? Sorry, Tolau with an underscore at the end of the name. How's it going? Good to see you. Merry Christmas Eve to you too. You join us just in time for the first Wu campaign mission, and thus the worst Wu campaign's character selection. I have, I'm basically kind of using this stream as a test to see how my coughing and spluttering is held up. It seems to have got better in the last couple of days, so now I'm sort of putting my voice for a bit of an extended test, i.e. stream for 2 hours and make some progress, be productive. I spent the last couple of nights just watching videos and doing barely anything. That's annoyed me. I like to be doing something when I have this free time in abundance. By doing something, I mean I want to be streaming and putting out content. So, now's your chance to pick a character, Tuwao. Unless you're in agreement with Jorgie and you would happily see Sun Quan be first up. I may have not chosen the best time to stream this, honestly, but I don't care. I want the practice. Well, it looks like Sun Quan's gonna get the nod here, by the looks of things. So, I guess Sun Quan it shall be for the first mission. Alright. So we shall equip the usual skills, boost, defense boost, attack boost, victory cry. I find these skills to be the best at the moment. There may be better skills later on, but anyway. Ooh. This guy uses an iron sword. Wow, we have some upgrades for that. That's handy. We have like ridiculous upgrades in fact. 1925? Holy smokes. We could have a lot of damage output to this. Monkey tongue. Merry Christmas Eve to you too, and I choose Sun Quan. Wow, he has some powerful weapons. I'm starting to wonder if I should perhaps keep the weapons to iron swords, just to make this... I don't know if giving him a higher tier weapon than this earlier mission would not make the mission a bit too ridiculous. Yeah, I think I'm just going to keep him on Iron Sword for this one. I think if we give him like a this, it might be a little too much power for an early mission. If this was a late mission, I'd gladly stick it to him. This is a bit... We'll, however, give him one iron swords at least have something on them. No. Just to try and keep it scaled a bit, we'll not use the most powerful weapons at the moment. But another one, an iron sword. Alright, let's do this.
Together, we shall forge a new world under the heavens.
Yeah. We'll see.
The wind has begun to blow.
The flagpole.
What's the matter, Honda?
Nothing. Well, the flagpole just broke in the wind. It doesn't seem like a good omen.
You're surprisingly sensitive. Quite unlike the side of yourself you show in battle.
There's no need to worry. The wind can blow as fast as it likes. All we have to do is run through the enemy even faster. Right, brother?
That's right. We shall become the gale that shreds Liu Biao.
It'll be fine. You can count on my father and my brothers.
Wow. She seems...
Yes. Well, if you all say so.
We do. I'm expecting big things from you too, Honda.
That hurt.
Now, Tigers of Suin, show the enemy your terrible claws.
Alright, looks like we're getting started right away.
First, we must wipe out the enemy forces immediately in front of us. This is it, everyone.
Alright, so I thought we might get a bit of an introduction to the camp, but not here, it seems. So, we're going to check out his... Now, because we're back to level 1 again, we unfortunately have a lot of our stuff locked at the moment, including our second EX attack and our other Muzu. So it's just a very simple EX 1 and just as one Muzu for now. Can't even use the 6 hits yet. So, Tornado Blaze. Alright, let's do this.
Trend.
That's his EX anyway. Oh. Oh, I'm supposed to ignore this guy, possibly. But I'm gonna kill him anyway. As well. There we go.
I refuse to die here. I shall withdraw for now.
Alright. So, for those who are wondering...
Begin the surge forward. Clan, this is no time to be holding back.
Indeed, brother. Let us show them the strength of the Soon family.
Thank
Ow.
You. Don't forget this deed. Come forth.
Wow, he's changing his weapon very quickly. Jesus. Ridiculously fast. Sun Quan seems alright to play. Kind of the average sword fighter, I suppose. I have to say, it's a nice change going back to a character that's not kind of powered up from the beginning. It's nice to be back on that cycle of having to re-earn all the skills and stuff again. So, should be fun. Now, for those who are wondering about that flagpole thing at the start, from what I was told when it came up in Dynasty Warriors 3, apparently if a flagpole breaks in a wind, it's... Wait on. The hell?
Nah, it's an ambush. Everybody, remain calm.
What's Wei Yan doing here?
I
Isn't he I guess he wasn't always with Shu to start with. Maybe he started out with Wu Biao. This is news to me. Maybe news to me, but I'm still gonna kill him. I doubt it's over yet, buddy.
This battle is mine.
I defeated. I retreat.
I speak in one sentences. We're back to our single movement bar as well for the time. But yeah, if a flagpole blows off in a wind or something like that, then basically it means death is coming for somebody. For those who are perhaps familiar with this mission from other Dynasty Warriors games, you may know what's about to happen on this mission. For those who don't, I'm keeping my mouth shut. Hey Draken, how's it going, man? Good to see you. And before you say, why isn't this Resident Evil 7 the demo? Well, the reason is simple. It's because I wanted to test my voice was working in good order. I mean, this stream could have been over in 10 minutes if my voice had been like, nope, not happening. As it is, I seem to be holding up so far.
Officer bows before the might of the Sun family.
It's like a bit of a jump in the dark. So no coughing and sputtering too much so far. Slacking on it. What? Heck no. This is the best my condition has been for a couple of days. I just got tired of sitting around and doing nothing.
Once we have surrounded the castle, we shall take it by force. The enemies inside won't stand a chance.
Alright, we need to go and take these bases.
Wow, I never knew you could fight like that.
I'm going to have your head.
Very nice.
This battle is mine.
Fire! Why am I not surprised that he... high ranking officer of... Why am I not surprised that fire is associated with Wu? Because I'm not, that's why.
Burn!
Do I have a horse?
I know everybody wishes for me to rule the land. That I should use the Imperial Seal to
bring an enemy. Oh wow, I should get a white horse, that's pretty good.
Yet we are loyal retainers of the Han. I do not know if I can follow a path that went against him.
Sumi sounds like Chu there saying that. What? Was that a woman? Yeah.
Come on, what are you waiting for? Let's get this fight started.
Well, I don't know if I would say they would do nothing, Draken. They're going to be hitting the back there. Quite a few powerful women in this game's war, Draken.
I shall return after reviewing my strategy.
This officer bows before the might of the Sun
family. Managed to switch out to a weaker element. And he's dead. See ya, dude. Okay, now we just gotta take over the back base over there. But yeah, if my voice holds up for this stream, my next stream is gonna be a stream of the Resident Evil 7 demo. I'm actually surprised my voice is holding up for this. Ooh, going underground. For about 2 seconds. I got too excited for that. Who's the guy in charge here? Shun Xiangyang, according to the lore anyway, Shun Xiangyang is considered a tomboy type figure. And yet this game's visuals portrays her as being something of a pixie. Some easily.
Time for one final blow. I'll let you go.
Gotcha.
This officer bows before the might of the Sun family.
All right, we've got all the... We've survived the castle.
I am not worried about surprise attacks. Those sort of tricks don't work.
Sure we do. Oh, yeah. Uh-oh.
Hondong, I want you and the others to attack the castle in fury.
This battle is mine.
Make sure you are ready.
Okay, this is my chance to shine. I'll simply enter the castle and annihilate the enemy. You know how to get someone's attention.
Wow, my horse cannot keep up with me again. This is just so... Oh, hello, One Pin. I'm afraid you're going nowhere. Your counter-attack unit is going to be stopped. Well, yeah, Shun Changchen actually was quite involved in the scheme of things for Wei. But again, I won't say much about that because no doubt we'll be going into quite the story with her. What is the counter-attack? I'm going to go deal with person here, just in case. Just keep that morale going high, you know, that kind of thing. Is he almost dead? Oh no, he's not. No, that's my friendly captain who is almost dead. No matter, this guy will be dead before then.
How could my tactics fail like that?
I wasn't aware you used it.
Bows before the might of the Sun family.
Okay. Now that we've done that, I guess we'll join the others up there, that side route. It looks like there's an underpass of some kind, anyway. It's pretty sweet. Excuse me. Yu Gong is withdrawing.
I am in your debt. We surround you, but the situation seems to have ground to a halt. What is the attack unit doing?
Quickly advance the. Ah, great. It appears that after all of that, we have to go the other way round. Eventually, when I can get over there. Oh god. Well, we're gonna have to do things the awkward way. Don't just go up there and kick down that side of the drawbridge. Nope. We have to go around the wrong way and do it ourselves. Yep. Look at these muddy, artistic looking planes. I'm not exactly sure as to where we're supposed to actually go in terms of attacking.
Our supplies won't hold out much longer. We must tighten our formation and press in on the enemy position.
Can't go up there.
These stupid whelps! Don't they know the battle's only just getting started?
If this keeps up, we are sure to suffer heavy casualties. We must take down the officer leading these archers.
Well, I would do, but I can't get up anywhere.
Prepare to hit them with everything we've got.
Ow. Oh, wonderful. Now they come out to play. At last. Now we can do something. Eventually. Well, now we need to go and open the drawbridge. Come on. Hit there.
I must be getting old. My body doesn't keep up with my thoughts.
I'm coming, guys. Please be patient. As soon as I can figure out how to get up there, that is.
someone doesn't get here fast, we're done for.
What am I doing? Oh, come on, this is the first mission, for fuck's sake. First mission. Seriously. Oh no, I don't instantly know what I'm doing for 30 seconds. Time for morale to instantly drop to shit. Why can't this work the other way around? Why are these morale changes so darn quick and so in favor of the enemy? Oh, this is the same Wong Song as he becomes an archer for Shu as well. I thought it was just a different guy. There we go. Can I have my morale back? No? I assume morale doesn't just miraculously return for my side, does it? What am I doing then? Am I supposed to kill the guy over there? Yes, I guess I was. Well, it's open now. I'm just going to go in and kill the chief.
We weren't clever enough to overcome this threat.
That's a better idea. Why not just kill the guy in charge?
Curse these dogs if you had Shu. I refuse to be beaten by the likes
of Shu.
This battle is mine.
I can't die just yet.
Well, about... There we go. And we got him.
It's over. Victory is ours.
Yeah!
Father!
Father!
Father! I, Liu Gong, have avenged Lord Huangzu!
No, I knew it. The wind today.
No, Father, you can't die.
You'll be fine, my dear. You don't need me around anymore. My son. You must now lead the House of Sun.
Wait, Father! We aren't ready yet!
The future belongs to the young. My children. Make it your own.
The Tiger of Jiangdong successfully drove Liu Biao out of Xiangyang. However, Sun Jian was struck and killed by an enemy arrow during the fighting. Despite his grief, Sun Ce gathered his troops together and returned to Wanshu. However, Wanshu refused to evaluate his accomplishments properly, simply let him languish beneath his command for 5 years. At this rate, the Tiger's claws would simply grow dull beneath the leadership of Wanshu. Filled with apprehension, Sun Ce decided to trade the Imperial Seal to Wanshu for his freedom. Wanshu readily agreed to his proposal, and Sun Ce was finally ready to strike out on his own. First, in order to obtain a base of operations, he was determined to capture Wujun, which is something. Stop being so fast! Together with his close friend, Zhou Yu, Sun Ce looking on the veteran Zhou Hung Gao for his support to the young tiger. I know it's a pause button, but I don't know what button it is. The roar of this pack of tigers was about to be heard throughout the regions of Wujun and Jiangdong. I really need to figure out what that pause button is. Okay. Maybe we do actually need to go with the pause button is. Sorry if I just sort of go back a set, but I just kind of... I do want to figure out what that pause button is so I can read it for future reference. So, don't mind me. What is the pause button? Ah, it's select. Right, okay. That's useful to know when the thing goes too fast. Okay. Skip all that now. Okay. I know that for future reference now. If it's going to look like it's going to be too fast, I'll just pause it ahead of time. And, yeah. Alright, so. After the first battle, Xiangyang fell to an arrow. It's pretty historical that Xiangyang falls in that fight, no matter what. Gets killed off by Lu Biao's assistant, Lu Dong. And thus, the Sun family moves on to a new era. Pointing to this guy. Well, now anyway. So, it looks like the Wu's first objective is to... learn how to not instantly fall apart and cripple themselves and lose all morale the first 2 minutes something bad happens. And the next thing they need to do after that is get some territory. So, we have three choices for this one. Do we play as Sun Se, young guy, or Shu Yu? Am I doing that Z right? Show you. Who shall I play as, chat? Who shall I play as this time? One guy, show you, or Sun Se? I definitely think my voice might be back. Good. I've got a lot of catching up to do. Just being part of the catch-up process. Come on, chat, this is your time to shine. Pick a character for me. I probably won't do too many missions tonight because, well, it's Christmas Eve and I don't want to overdo my voice at the moment. Hey, Starman27, good to see you. You vote for Sun Se, huh? Nice. Well, Sun Quan was alright to play as, although it'd be fun to see some of these characters with all their skills unlocked later. Of course. I definitely think giving him only the first tier weapon was a good choice. We would have probably breezed through that Marist map if not for the that pick. So you can sort of balance the fights yourself a bit. Anyone else got a pick? Jorgi, Tuau, Draukun, anyone else? Anyone? Want to pick a character? Saw a couple of new, one or two, saw someone called Dian Shi, but no idea who she is. Sun Se is the best, lol. Now that's your argument, is it, Starman? Sun Se is the best. Alright, well, he's going to be underleveled at the moment, but we are just starting out with Wu, our second faction. Oh, Tawau wants to see Show You. So we have a tie now in the chat. Need someone who. Anyone else got a pick? Remember, these are all new characters. I haven't played any of them. This is a new faction. Well, it's not. I'm familiar with Wu, but it's a new faction in terms of this game, I mean. Anyone else want to pick a character? Okay then, this is not awkward at all now. Oh great, now we have to pick between one or two. Because there's no one else voting. Crumbs and biscuits. Alright, well, I guess I'm just going to have to pick one of these two based off the reasoning of the person who voted for them. And since Starman 27 says Sunsei is the best, whoa, that'll do for a reason for me, I guess. So I guess we'll pick Sunsei. Now, he also has quite a few weapon upgrades too, up to Goblin Fist, but again, we'll use the first tier weapon. Now, he uses something called a Tomfa, which is kind of like a baton, basically, a security baton type thing. So we'll be using that. Because this is an early mission, we will again be using the, we won't be using the upgraded stuff for now. I don't think it will balance the mission out very well if we did, so we'll go for this one. Fine. Okay. So. Oh, we're actually up to level 8. So that's pretty good. I think it's level 25 where we unlock all the skills, and EX skills and Muzu. So if we can level up a few more times in the next battle, that would be fantastic. Alright, let's rock.
I can't wait to get out there and make my mark.
And here we go. So this is our first time to being in a camp. And no doubt won't be the last. So, and while we're here, we might as well sell some weapons that we don't need. Sell that one because it's an inferior version. Oh wow, there's two here. Sell that one. Leave that as is for now. Okay. So, got a couple of things. Let's go talk to people and see what the Wu officers and soldiers are like. Things were terrible under one shoe. I was worried that Master Sunsei would waste away in his service. We're broke out! We're free of one shoe. It's time to form the Wu Empire, etc, etc. Have you heard about an officer named Taisa Chi? He's a powerful warrior who serves Li Liao. He's won the affection of everyone around him. His master treats him coldly. I wonder why. Master Sunsei treats everyone nicely. Taisa Chi. He will be fun. The Sun family has long been served by officers such as Huang Gai, Cheng Pu, and that one with the funny eyes. I'm sorry, I've forgotten his name. One with the funny eyes, huh? Now that Master Sun Jian is gone, must all come together to support Master Sunsei. Absolutely, you're going to support me to the bitter end. Boils. If we win this battle, we can base our operations from here. How exciting! You know, there's a certain art to reading the art of war. Oh, really? There's a certain art to reading a book. Fucking hipster. Ye very old hipster. You know, you can't just read this book. You have to read it in a certain way, under a certain light, and a certain time of the day. Anyway, I wonder what kind of man the princess will marry. I can't think of any candidates for her at the moment. What fucking princess are you talking about? What princess? The one of these two? Okay. I guess we must refer to this Lady Lian Shi. Apparently comes from a family that used to be very powerful. She must have been for what? The Sun family was impressed with her talents. Now she serves as a bodyguard for the princess. Oh, sorry. She's not the princess. The princess is Sun Xiangyang? Okay. That's the only way Dynasty Warriors game's been lying to me about Shun Xiangyang. I thought she was a tomboy, not a princess. Whatever, anyway. Well, you aren't the only ones impressed with her talents. I wish she'd protect me, too. Put that boner away, you. I know that deep down there is someone special whom Lady Liangxi cares a great deal about. Yes, that person is Lord Sun Quan. He is lucky to be adored by such a strong woman. Well, this is the first time I've even seen this Liangxi. Never heard of her before. I believe she was introduced in the 7th Dynasty Warriors. Princess, where has Lord Sun Quan gone? My brother Quan is off on other business now. He will rejoin us later on. But why do you ask, Liangxi? You always seem worried about my brother. No, that's not exactly the case. But I can't take my eyes off either of you, Princess, for different reasons. At least that is how I feel. What's with you, Liangxi? Don't make it sound like you're in so much danger. Is that her eyes rolling or something there? Oh, she's got more dialogue, apparently. This time I send a character to have a repeated dialogue option, yeah? I will risk my life to protect you, Princess. That is how I can repay the debt I owe the Sun family. My brother Quan and Huan Dang will be arriving later. Until then, we have to do the best we can. Okay. Well, I guess I'll get to know about Liangxi later. Wu belonged to the Sun family's great ancestor, Lord Sun Tzu. He even wrote his book, The Art of War, here. And now, hundreds of years later, we have Lord Sun Tse. He is bound to be skilled in battle. Sure. We must conquer and retake Wu. This is surely our most pressing business. The Sun family's winds of change will begin blowing here. Wow. He is one heck of a muscular man. He will be fun. I bet he'll be really fun to play as later on. Size of this place, it's fucking huge. Jesus, for a small fort, look at the size of the walls. That just occurred to me now, this is huge. Holy shit, they should have built tall stuff back then. All right, the time for talking is over, the time for battle is now. All right, show you long-haired man, let's see what the deal is. I'm sorry, show you I did not think we would end up in this position. Oh no, Sensei. Actually, I'm rather pleased. Rather than taking over Sun Jian's base, you and I get to embark on a new quest for power. Hehe, thanks. I know I can always rely on you. Okay, first we need to set up a base to start from, and that should definitely be here in Wu. Yes, this land belongs to the Sun family, though right now it is being held by others. We will defeat the usurpers and claim this land for the Sun family. The people of Wu are sure to accept you with open arms. Yes, I know what must be done. Now we just need to go and do it. Wan and Huan Dang should be here soon too. So, let's begin our fight. Time to save. Check the move list. Okay, we can use the second EX attack for now, but we have at least got up to 5 hits now. The barge attacks faster than the eye can follow. Tiger Fist! Smash the enemy with all your might!
So the enemy forces in Wailing Castle refuse to come out and fight us, do they?
This music sounds familiar. I'm trying to figure out... Sorry, which one was this EX again? Oh, it's his first move. Whoops. Excuse me.
Leave it to me. I know a thing or two about capturing bases.
Alright. Let's get some capturing done. I could see those hand movements. They're not faster than the eye was slower. See, I can see him attack. We're not faster than the eye could follow at all. See ya. There's a very satisfying smacking sound that you get when you use Sunsei's weapons. Very satisfying. I do quite like it. You get a real sense of hitting someone with a wooden stick. There we go, we got the Northwest Garrison. Now we just gotta take the others. And how do we do that? Oh, the gate opens, that's nice. Come on, let's go! Oh, swipe, we shower water. Awesome. Alright, gatekeeper. Tiger Fist! Punch, punch, punch. Oh, Tai Chi Chi has appeared.
That fool! I ordered him to wait. Trying to embarrass me.
We're in.
All right.
Well, it's down.
Excellent fighting.
Oh yeah. All the garrisons are ours. Good.
Well fought, my dear friend.
Smackety smack. Ah! Let's see, that's locked. So now we have to go all the way about. Just to take out Tyson Chi. Tyson Chi being a pretty big deal on this map. In other Dynasty Warriors games, and no doubt will be here too.
Make oh, easy. Here I come.
He's powered up too.
Come and show me what you've got. This is gonna be fun.
Oh, look at me, I'm fast. Hooray! He's with temporary withdrawing.
Not only did Tyson Sir contravene my orders, but he got himself defeated as well. If only he waited as I told him to.
One down. Many more to go.
Tyson Sir has been defeated. So wrong, we must put a halt to the enemy immediately.
Very well. Open the gates and prepare to advance.
All right, we're in.
Our strategy to clear out the enemy was a success. Now, to take down Zero and Shui Lu and capture the castle.
I just realized, did I even show up the chance to show off the rage last time of Sun Quan in the last fight?
Come on, what are you waiting for?
Right.
Let's get this fight started.
First punch everything. Yeah, I just love those smack. Anyone else with me on that? With those Tonfa smacks? There's a real sense of weapon impact with them, which I've either really just not noticed with other characters, or I don't know. Maybe this is why Starman 27 considers him the best, though. Or is there other reasons? Again, there's fire!
One down! Many more to go!
What are you doing? You're not taking this place on my watch.
Our next target is Liu Yao and the enemy main camp.
Okay. Yay! Hey, we can take that area to the right without needing to go back. Hey, Bemused. Oh no, he's back again. Nice achieve. I'll let the ladies know, Bemused. Oh no, Tyson Sir, is a bit stronger this time. This will make the fight a bit tricky.
You know how to fight, right? It's been fun having you as an opponent, Tyson Sir. You're the most unusual sort.
I find fighting you most entertaining.
I must be getting old. My body doesn't keep up with my thoughts.
Oh no, they're in trouble. Yeah, eat that.
Let's get this over with already.
Rage time! I had to bust it out early because I was about to get counter-attacked. Not bad. Not the best time to show the rage, but I was about to be Muzu countered. And since he was a powered up officer, it could have been fatal. His skill with whacking people with tompers.
Patience, sir, how dare you! You have brought shame to my kingdom. Return to the main camp. It is your job to defend.
Brother, I am sorry to have kept you waiting. However, I am here now to fight by your side.
Easy fall. Ah, backup's here. Hooray. So are you then, Bemused?
One down. Many more to go.
He's in the back, huh? Hooray! If I should do something feeling fat, you just ate three Bixit selection boxes. Oh goodness me, you are.
I've got no hope of defeating this lot. I'm sorry. I surrender.
Whoa, wow. I was going down like crazy for this guy's what?
That's some excellent fighting.
Yes, you deal quite a blow to the enemy's morale. Now, to find a way to approach the enemy main camp from the
enemy. Holy crap! I'm like the last bar where they fell apart within seconds of having to do something.
For an opportunity to test my new tactics.
Hey, block all you want, pal. The final part of my attack seems to not care for blocking.
This is gonna be fun. I shall return after reviewing my strategy.
Smack.
One down. Many more to go.
It appears that my voice is ready. I am ready to stream once again. As per normal.
Well fought, my dear friend.
Actually quite fun so far. Can you believe it? I'm having fun. Honestly, this kind of pacing and scaling, this does start to feel like I'm playing the old Dynasty Warriors games a bit. Almost.
All right.
We almost bought the entire visit. Oh, you do.
Back for now. One down. Many more to go.
I think I've heard him say that in other games. That quote, one down, many more to go.
You're going to face me. Step forward.
Oh, I'm going to face you, alright. We're going to face the super fast, not visible to the sap. Oh no. Now why do I ask Bemuse, why have you eaten three selection boxes? Like, how big were these selection boxes? I have a bad feeling about this. Yeah, he's still as strong as he was the second time. We'll have to be careful. I'm gonna try and build up my rage meter. Just in case I have to pull off a rage counter again. In fact, I think he has a little bit more defense and health than last time.
How do you feel about joining our side instead?
I am currently in the service of Master Liu Yao. Betraying is more than I can bear.
Fair enough. Well, what happens if we defeat your master? Then what would you say, buddy? Would that change your mind, maybe? If there's no master left, you can't betray them, right? Anyone with half a brain like Owl knows exactly what's going to happen at the end of this mission.
I shall admit defeat and withdraw. Maybe someday we can fight on the same side.
The gates are right. Let's head straight for their leader.
You hate the early shit early.
One down. Many more to go. All right.
I refuse to handle this. Prepare to meet your end.
I am ashamed to have required aid, but thank you for coming.
All right. One down. Many more to go.
You've done it, my lord.
Master Liu Yao, my apologies. As a warrior and as a man, I wish to live a just and true life. So, from this day, my life is yours, Master Sun Tzu.
Thank you, Taishi Tzu.
What on earth? Ye old bro fist.
Look, my lord. This is your land. And these are your men. Yes. I finally feel it. I stand as the head of the House of Sun. Everyone! The land is in turmoil. To be honest, I've no idea what'll happen next. But, with your help, I'm going to do everything I can to make it right! Let's go!
The House of Wu stands proudly in Jiangdong, and we are its people! Yeah!
Okay. Together, Sun Tzu and the officers that fought alongside him conquered Wujun in an instant. The reputation of Wu spread far and wide across the troubled land. Afterwards, Sun Tzu joined forces with Liu Bei and others to defeat Wan Shu, who had proclaimed himself emperor. Due to his seemingly unstoppable advance, the people came up with a name for Sun Tzu, the Little Emperor. Oh, sorry, the Little Conqueror. They were comparing him to Xuang Yu, the legendary hero that was known as the Conqueror. 4 years later, Cao Cao attacked Wan Shao of Huabei after building up his strength in the Central Plains region. The two of them prepared to engage in a large-scale battle on the fields of Guangdu. This created the perfect opportunity. Sun Tzu rose up to strike Cao Cao from behind while he was preoccupied. If he could rescue the Emperor and gain control of the Central Plains region, there would be little that could be said to stop Wu. Based on this incredible opportunity in the morale of Sun Tzu, Shou Yu, Sun Quan, I'm struggling to pronounce these Chinese pronunciations, and Su Tai rose considerably. However, a dark shadow was slowly descending upon them. Dun dun dun! Excuse me. Alright. So. Oh gee, I wonder what the dark shadow could be. I wonder if the title of the mission does not give away what the mission is going to be about. The Little Conqueror in Peril. Oh no! I wonder if Sun Tzu is going to be put in peril in this mission. Perish the fort. Alright, so, we've already played as Sun Tzu. We've already played as Sun Quan. So that leaves two choices for this one for new characters. We have Shou Yu or Zhu Tai. I can't remember that thing from last time. Zed with a Shong Shou Tai. Ah, forget it. I'm always looking at half these pronunciations wrong and half of them correct. Because it's like learning a language. So who shall I pick from the two remaining characters that I haven't played as yet so far? Zhu Tai or Shou Yu? As you can see, they both got skills. It's like, oh, you played as him? Oh, you played as him. Oh, you haven't played as him. Makes it much easier to decide who I've not played as now. Couldn't they have just named them Dave and Bob? Dave and Bob. Hey, legit_pancakes96. Good to see a new face around here, even if it is a legitimately tasty pancake from Division S96 of the bakery. I'm glad you're not one of the illegitimate pancakes that came out of that factory. Although, then again, last time I mocked someone for their name slightly, they said there was a reason for this name. Well, that's one vote for Zhu Tai because he's my favourite. I've seen some of your Dynasty Warriors vids on YouTube. Oh no. Yes. I've done a few. Not just the fists, but also of Dynasty Warriors 3 and Xtreme Legends. Ah, those were fun times. Now YouTube is just... But now YouTube is a dying breed. Ah, just put the live stream as you. So anyone, any other votes from the chats? We have a very convincing argument for seeing Zhou Tai in this. Anyone else gonna pick between Shou Yu and Zhu Tai? Come on, chat, this is your chance to pick character. This probably will be the last mission of this stream. But I'm really surprised, my voice is doing great. I've definitely chose the right time to come back, so I'm very infused to stream that one. I guess we're just going to be playing as Zotai then. Alright. So Zotai it is then. Alright, so this guy uses a curved sword. Ah, he doesn't have many upgrades for this, so we don't have to worry about using higher tier stuff. Let's do something different from the ground. Alright. Yeah, shut up, I know, game. Don't start. Alright, so let us play as Zotai.
I come to serve.
Yeah, that voice, man. Idea! You missed. How far away were you away from that deer?
Got away. No meat for us tonight, Zhou Yu.
Huh?
Zhou Yu? Hey, Chuan! Zotai! Where have they gone to?
Soon, sir.
Huh?
You have taken Wujun, and call yourself the Little Conqueror?
Xu Gong. And who are you?
Look back on the path you have walked, one twisted by power. The cries of hatred and flames of anger shall now become a vortex. Suck down into it. You shall meet your end here.
Hey, what are you talking about?
I'll say. Since when is Dynasty Warriors a horror game? Alright, so let's check his move list here. Oh, we've leveled up enough that we can unlock our aerial attack now. This guy can use both his moves. EXs, sorry. So, high speed strike, so he's a flash, it's not any movement. His attack is void. Aerial is wind. Alright, let's. Second, two, and three. Alright. Let's go! Whoa! What the hell?
These are Xu Gong's men. Is that the person who was after you, Sun Tzu?
Yes. It seems he ordered straight the grudge against
me. Xu Gong had been
working for him as well. One who could perform all sorts of weird tricks.
Oh no!
There's something unsettling about these enemies. Surely they can't be phantoms as well.
Ooh, it's getting scary! Huh. That's weird. He always keeps out his, he always keeps his sword in his sheath until he's in battle. Oh, have we finally found the guy waiting these phantom dudes or something. Pretty phantom soldiers once again. I guess. What is exactly the mission here? Okay, I think we have to. Oh, we found him. Very nice.
Return to nothingness.
It seems the phantom soldiers have disappeared. Let's hurry up and get out of this forest.
What has happened to this forest? It's as though it's been cursed or something. I will protect you, Lord Su Chuan.
Thank you, Jotai. I knew I could rely on
you. Yo, I am getting blinded by his weird attack. Wow, he blinds you with his attacks half the time. Crazy. Oh no.
These arrows keep raining down on us. We have to get out of here.
I strike like the wind. I'm the one who commands the archers. Got it. Gotta go find the archer guy. Well, he wasn't here. Oh. Oh, no. Everything's gone to... Some of it's gone to daylight. You see that? Everything just went to daylight suddenly. Now it's gone back to this dark weirdness again. Well, I guess we have an exit, but we better find the guy who commands the archers. And kill him. Ah, found it.
Return to nothingness.
Wow.
The arrows have stopped. That should make passing through this forest much easier.
I've already found an escape, in fact.
That's the way out of this forest, I'm sure of it.
Yay! We're finally leaving the creepy forest. Quite a different change from this game. I haven't seen this game try and go a bit horror before. Tends to treat sorcery. Dynasty Warriors tends to treat its sorcery and magic with a lot of goofiness, like you saw with that CLC guy.
The entire land, even. That is why I am here to put an
and it's daylight suddenly. No one wants to comment on that at all.
Looking for an opportunity to test my new tactics. Well done. You performed admirably.
You plan on killing me, do you? Very well, but I'll take you with me. You will walk the path of the Conqueror. And clash with Lord Cao Cao. Don't you see? The more men of your caliber step forward, the worse this chaos will become.
Shut your mouth! All I have to do is defeat them all!
You fool. Ganji. I leave the rest to you.
Your revulsion for this time of war is perfectly clear to me.
What?
Now die, dogs of chaos.
What on earth is this?
Victory will be ours. Crush every last one of the enemy.
Cao Cao's forces have appeared.
Cao Cao's men, we have no hope of taking on anybody in this condition. We're alone again. Is our first priority.
Something tells me these aren't Cao Cao's forces somehow.
So you use the biro and get my brother out of here.
Thank you. Zhou Tai, please look after Master Sun Quan.
Okay.
Let's cross
capture the base and
enemy head on. Please, Zhou Tai, I need your help. For my brother's sake.
Whoa! And that jawbitch just rose up.
Like you came all this way for nothing. Sorry, but you're not getting past.
I'm.
Unless we defeat the enemy and lower the drawbridge.
I don't think these are Cao Cao's forces at all. Not one bit. Wow. We just freeze him in place. Dang, man. That's pretty good. See ya, Shahu won.
Officer has been defeated. We should be able to lower the drawbridge.
Yay, we did it. Let's keep going.
All right. Let's head south. We'll take out the enemy base and draw their attention. They will need me in the next fight. Sorry.
All of Cao Cao's forces right now are probably just fighting one Shao at this point.
Well done. Most impressive. Come on, what are you waiting for? Let's get this fight started.
Great, Zhou Tai. Keep it up.
I wonder if this is some kind of 4th, 5th faction. Excuse me.
So let's make as much noise as we can over here. We want to attract the attention of as many enemies as possible.
I'll let you go for now. Don't think you've won.
I will slay as many officers as necessary to fulfill my duty.
Got him! Ta-da!
I will do what it takes.
Thank you, Zhou Tai. It's a great relief knowing that you are by my side.
I'll let you go.
I wonder if all these guys are part of some kind of 4th faction. Like, remember Shoshi and the Wei historical. Remember Shoshi in the hypothetical Wei campaign saying similar things?
It seems we thwarted that enemy element. I can only hope my brother is unharmed.
It's our dual hooked friend. He's not very much fun to play. I'm glad we beat him up. Fun.
I will slay as many officers.
My existence only serves to deepen the chaos. You should go to the point. Don't let me cloud your judgment. You are no warmonger. If you were, there is no way I would be so bloody.
Oh hey, Lady Dion has shown up. Also powered up. I wonder how he predicts this battle will go. No, no, son, sir, please don't die.
Don't have any more time to waste. I have to take care of this myself.
Uh-oh. Oh, not more reinforcements. Can't be having that. Who else is here then? Oh no!
A little further. It's longer at the last.
Sensei's not doing very well. You want me to go and defeat him, huh? Oh, he's been defeated! That was fast. Fucking hell. Adios, sell them. Adios, Satan Doom.
Blast! We were so close to escaping.
Sir, are you alright?
Dread. We came. Listen, I'm sorry you have to see me like this.
God. To kill him before he could cause us any trouble.
Great, Jotai. Keep it up.
Where's the master strategist? The suit tie does seem pretty fun to play, would you, Frankie? I'll give you that. Got some excellent attacks, that's for sure.
Return to nothingness.
I had fun, but it's about time for me to
return to nothingness.
All right, the gates are open. Let's get you out of here, sir.
Yeah, let's get you out fast.
Well done. Most impressive.
Alright, now it's time to find out the truth, I guess. You know how to fight, Sun Tzu. Just move away. Oh, he is doing. Good. Yay! We did it!
Okay. We made it out of there somehow.
Still, I can't believe that Xu Gong was in league with Cao Cao.
He claimed our lord was walking the path of a conqueror.
Ridiculous. I'm trying to sell out my brother, and even hiring some pathetic conjurer of tricks.
It was Ganji, wasn't it?
Sun Tzu!
I wouldn't call them tricks, exactly. Juan! Father entrusted our family's legacy to me. Now, it's my turn to entrust it to you.
What are you talking about, brother?
It's... all yours, now. Oh.
Okay. So far, the Wu campaign has been 2 major deaths. This is a very optimistic faction we're fighting for here, that's for sure. God damn it. Alright. Although the forces of Wu managed to drive off Zugong, it was Sun Ce in the process. Just before his death, Sun Ce entrusted the future of Wu to his younger brother, Sun Quan. Sun Quan cancelled the invasion of Xuzhang and instead focused on bringing stability to the land surrounding Jiangdong. 8 years later, Cao Cao rapidly expanded his strength after defeating Wan Shao in the north. In an effort to oppose Wu, he began to march his troops south. Opinions were divided within Wu whether to submit to Cao Cao's invasion or fight against it. Just then, Liu Bei and his strategist, Zhuge Liang, appeared after having been pursued by Cao Cao. As a result, Shou Yu, Lu Su, and others recommend that they ally with Liu Bei and oppose Cao Cao together. Faced with their enthusiasm, Su Quan decided to engage Cao Cao's forces in battle. Sun Quan allied with Liu Bei and went to meet Cao Cao's giant navy at Chibi. Lu Su, Hong Guai, Han Dong, and Shun Xiangjiang were about to set the waters of the Great River Wang. So, we're already 4 missions into this campaign and we're at this point already. This is just gonna at this point in the Wei campaign, this was the big turning point for Wei, and this was about 10 missions into it, so we are definitely dealing with a much later timeline here, it would seem. And it looks like we're gonna have a choice of an entirely new cast for next time, since all of these, I've never even played this guy before. It must be another one of the new ones that came through in either 7 or 8. This should be fun for next time, I feel. Yeah. So let's just see how the stages have gone down, shall we? Oh, we don't know any of the star conditions yet, but we didn't meet any of them. Oh, wow. There was a branch off point on this mission as well. Wow. It looks like this mission is just a one-way path, though. It's not the turning point for the Wu faction. Wow. I guess we'll only find out the star things once we get to that turning point where we need them. Or maybe when... I forget when I... I forget when I got to find out about the conditions for these. It looks like the first mission and the third have an alternate branching point already. And it looks like the Battle of Chibi is just going to be a straight up linear path this time, as opposed to what it was in the Wei mission. Should be interesting. So, what have you all thought of the Wu campaign so far? Having seen it on stream, do you have any thoughts on the Wu campaign so far? Thank you to all 12 viewers here tonight. Thank you to Abehoss _, to Bemused, Saladin 531, The Lerp, Laser Game Explosion, Legit Pancake S96, Niskurin, Starman 27, This Dude to Wow, and my moderator Drowken for being here. Like a couple of workers worked and did working things. It appears that although I'm still not 100%, I am more than percentiled enough to be able to stream once again, which is good news. Yay! This means that I can get back to streaming at last, and thus to not have to spend my evenings nearly staring at a computer monitor, but instead can participate, get back to what I like doing. So, this was fun. It was kind of nice to go back to level 1 and build up characters once again. Build up that feeling of a new faction. I don't know what this game is, so it was okay. Well, Bemused, if you tune in for future parts, you will find out what this game is all about. It is quite fun, if you like what you see anyway. I definitely recommend picking it up if you like what you see on this stream. I don't know if it's on sale though during the summer Steam sales. Next time I do stream, however, I have promised Draukin that I will be covering the Resident Evil 7 demo, and that will be my next stream. After that, I will be getting back to, well, back to the grind of Plutonia 2 and this more Wu campaign stuff. But yeah, thanks you all for watching. Hope it's been fun this Christmas Eve to spend a bit of time watching me kill Chinese people in the past. And have a Merry Christmas to one and all.